Hi, good afternoon. I am going to do a 20-minute dancy flow today. You need a ball for part of it. Most of it you won't need a ball. And it's just to kind of have fun and get your body moving a little bit in different ways that you normally wouldn't move. I'm Dr. Megan Klunk, and thanks for joining me today. So you're going to begin in a standing position, and I want your heels to be connected. Your toes are slightly apart. You're going to begin bending your knees, and you're going to go down as far as you're able to. So your heels are going to lift up. Try not to sit onto your heels though. And then press the heels down into the floor as you straighten out the legs. So you're going to lower yourself down. Lift the arms up, don't shrug the shoulders up. Inhale as you lower. And then exhale, lift. So if your knees are bothering you with this, don't go down quite so low. And now I want you to stay here. You're going to try to rotate from belly button up and face forward. And rotate belly button up. And face forward, press the heels down, and straighten out the legs. Good. Lower yourself back down again. And now you're going to side bend over to your left. Come back up. Side bend over to the right. Come back up. Press the heels down, and lower the arms. Good. Go ahead and widen the legs out. That is a quad burner there. Your feet are pointing out to the sides. You're going to bend the knees and press to straighten. Inhale to bend. Exhale to straighten. And now stay in that bent knee position. You're going to rotate to your left and face forward and rotate right and face forward. Reach the ball down to the floor. You're going to roll the ball out forward as you straighten the legs. Drop your head down. And then bend the knees as you roll the ball back in. So roll the ball out in front of you as you straighten up the legs. And bend. And one more time. And then stay in that bent knee position. You're going to open your left arm out to the side, rotate through the spine, and place the hand down, and rotate to the right, and place the hand down, and rotate, stay rotated. You're going to roll the ball out in front of you, and pull it back in, inhale, reach, exhale, pull it in, one more time. Pull it back in, replace your hand, and switch sides, open up, and roll the ball ahead, pull it back in, roll it out, and back in, one more time, and back in, straighten out the legs, walk your feet back in under your hips, soften the body over the legs, and roll yourself up to standing with control. Nice job. Okay, now you're going to take the ball with you and get the dirt off your back. Place the ball in between your ankles, and you're going to turn your feet slightly off to the right side of your mat. So your shoulders are staying square forward. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Exhale, roll yourself down on the diagonal, hands meet the mat. Walk yourself out into a plank position. You're rolled onto the left side of your left foot. And now I want you to tap your knee down to the mat and press back up. So you're tapping down, pressing up, tapping down, pressing up. Pike the hips up. Walk your hands back towards your feet. Roll yourself up over that leg. Inhale, arms come overhead. And then exhale, lower the arms. Switch your feet off to the left side of the mat. Shoulders stay square forward. Inhale, sweeping overhead. And exhale. Rolling yourself down. Walk yourself out into that weird plank position so shoulders stay square. Feet are off to the side. Tap the right knee down and lift up. And tap and lift. Make sure you're lifting from your center. And lift one more time. And lift, pike the hips up. Walk the hands back and roll yourself back up. Straighten out the feet. Now the ball is going to go in between your inner thighs. Again, feet are off to the right side, shoulder square, inhale. And exhale, roll yourself forward. Walk out into that weird plank. And now I want you to tap your knees down. You're going to fold the elbows into your sides and press up. Fold in and press. Inhale to lower. Exhale, lift. Inhale. And one more time. Good. And then roll around the spine as you reach the hips back towards the heels. Roll through the spine and pull yourself forward. Good. Try not to fall into that forward posture. And roll yourself forward again. And one more time back. And pull yourself forward. Good. Lift up into that plank position. Walk your hands back. Round the spine up to ceiling. And now switch sides. Arm circle overhead. Good. Round yourself forward. Walk out into the weird plank. And drop the right knee down. Elbows fold in. Actually, sorry. Let's point the hands in towards each other. We're going a little faster today. Elbows go out to the sides and press up. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale one more time. Good. And now shift your weight back. You can straighten out your hands a little bit. You're rounding your spine back towards your heels. And float yourself forward, opening up through the collarbones. Rounding back again. And pulling yourself forward. And one more time. And pull yourself forward. Nice job. Lift up into plank. Walk yourself back. And pull up through the spine. Good. All right, so we're going to remove the ball. Place it off to the side for now. Your legs are straight out in front of you. Hopefully that's... I really don't think we're going to use that again. At least for this class. So arms are out to the sides here. I want you to slide your left hand along the mat. And you're going to straighten your right leg out from your hip and then lift yourself up. Oh boy, that's a little harder than I thought, especially with the gravel. So slide out and extend, lift that leg and lift yourself back up. So I'm not going to go the whole way out just because I'm kind of limited with space, but if you can, straighten this arm out the whole way and then lift back. And lower down, leg extends straight out from the hip. And lift back up. And lower down. Now I want you to stay there. We're gonna lift that leg up a little bit and tap it down. And lift and lower. So stay lifted out of this bottom shoulder. Begin making circles here. Make that leg nice and easy. Sorry, slipping in my eye. And now other way. Keep that leg as straight as you can get it. Good. Swing the leg around. and then drop down onto your right elbow. Make sure you're not hanging out here. You're lifted nice and strong. You can almost float up off of that elbow. Sorry. Lift and lower. First. And begin circling the leg. And circle the other way. Swing the leg around, bring yourself up. Now we're going to switch it a little bit. So you're going to take your hands onto the mat and swing your leg more to the back instead of the side. And then lift yourself up, reaching your hand towards your foot. So your leg circles around, your upper body rotates towards the mat, and then circle the leg around and reach fingers to toes. And press back up. And now I want you to stay in this position. Let's drop down onto your elbows. If your spine doesn't tolerate this rotation very well, you can square your hips as well. And you're just going to lift this leg up and lower down. And lift and lower. Stay lifted out of your center, out of your elbows. And now bend that knee a little bit, and now lift that whole piece up and down here. Shoulders are staying square. And now as you straighten the leg out, you're going to lift it up. As you lower it down, you're going to bend, lift, straighten, lower, bend. Two more here. And one more. Good. Straighten that leg out. Swing it around. And then cross that foot over. Hug the knee in. And rotate the spine towards that knee. Make sure you're propped up nice and tall here. So now you're going to take your hands, rotate the chest towards the mat, swing your left leg back behind you, and then reach it around as you press the hands away. So circle around, drop down, and press back up and reach. Circle around again, press up and reach. Two more times. Now stay down here. Prop up onto your elbows. That leg is reaching back behind you. And you're going to lift and lower here. So shoulders and chest are square to the mat. And you're lifting and lowering that leg. And now bend the knee and lift and lower here. Little pulses. Two more. Find length through the back of the neck. And now you're going to lower that leg down. Extend it to lift it. Lower down. Extend, lift. Three more. And two. And one. And lift. Swing it around. Plant that foot down. Hug the knee in. And find a nice tall spine here. Your way into a seated position here. I want you to straighten your right leg out. You're holding on to what you can reach. Walk your hand and yourself down the leg. And then you're going to climb the tree back up. I have some friends that are really going to love this one. You might have some flashbacks from doing this exercise. next one, I want you to stay up, hold on to your ankle with your opposite hand, and reach out, look back at your back hand, return the hand, and lock yourself down. Nice job. So now I want you to float your opposite leg into a tabletop position. We're going to inhale, begin circling that leg around, exhale up and around, and hold. Inhale, exhale, up and hold. So the challenge here is to keep your tabletop leg and hip nice and sturdy and straight. And now reverse the circle. Tabletop leg down into the mat. Lower your other leg nice and straight. Try to press into your left heel and lift the hips equally up off that mat and back down. And press up and lower. So you're using more of that left glute to lift the hips up. Two more times. Make sure you're not just arching from your back, you're lifting your hips up and keeping the pelvis level and square. Last time, stay lifted. You're going to swap legs with your hips lifted. Straighten out the other leg and lower down. Good, now lift your left leg up. Climb the tree on the left side. And walk yourself back down. And climb back up. The lower back isn't pulling away from the mat. Good. Replace that foot on the mat. Straight leg lowers flat onto the mat. Press the hips equally up and tap the lower back down. Exhale and lift. So most of that weight is in the right heel here. Your left leg is staying nice and straight and kind of light. Two more times. And last time. Good. Hug the knees in. And now you're going to hold the backs of the thighs. Find a little bit of rocking here. Find your balance position. Bring your hands to the outsides of your legs and press your legs out into your hands. Hands into your legs.